Hi students, I am Jyoti Miss, your computer teacher. How are you all? I hope you all are safe at home with your parents. We are very glad to reach you like this by using St. Anne's High School app. So children, welcome to our online classes. I think you all of you know about computer class timetable. I already sent this timetable in your WhatsApp groups. So children, follow the timetable, watch the videos and learn the lessons properly. Keep a separate notebook for the computer subject and write down the notes and work what I am going to give. So children, today onwards we are going to start our computer classes. Shall we start children?
Okay children, all of you open your textbook and follow the lesson. Our first lesson is the computer system. See page number 5 in your textbook. The first lesson is the computer system. Already in last year class, we learned what is a computer, how it works, and what are the uses of computer, in which places we are using computer, that all things we learned in last year class. Okay children, in last year class, what we learned, computer having 4 parts. Those are keyboard, mouse, CPU, monitor, like that we learned, no? And printer, scanner, those also we learned in last year class. Now today, we are going to learn different parts of computer, how they are divided regarding to their working functions. Okay, now see children, page number 5. A computer is an electronic machine that is used to do calculations at very high speed. It can produce data, process data and even run machines. So children, what is a computer? It is an electronic machine. Means computer works with electricity. That all you know, no? And without electricity, computer should not work. And it can do calculations at very high speed. That also we learned in last year class. And here, it can produce data, process data and even run machines. Here, we are going to learn in this class what is data, how it process and how it give results. That all we are going to learn in this lesson. Children, next, a computer has different parts that together make it work. It consists of the following parts. Children, here, computer having different parts. Computer means nothing but of its only one part. It is a combination of different parts like keyboard, mouse, monitor, CPU. These all parts are combined together. It is called a computer. Okay, children. Now, here, computer parts are mainly divided into 4 types. Regarding to their working functions. Regarding to their working functions like keyboard, how the keyboard will work, how the monitor will work, how the CPU will work. Regarding to their working functions, computer parts are mainly divided into 4 parts. What are those? See here, input devices, processing devices, memory devices, output unit. See once again, input unit are input devices, processing devices, memory devices, output unit are output devices. Once you see, what is input unit? What is input unit? Children, listen carefully. What is input unit? Input unit means to enter data. To enter data. Nothing but of what we are giving instructions or what we are typing into the computer, giving data into the computer, that is called input unit. We will see briefly in next few minutes what's going there. So see, input unit means to enter data. For example, keyboard, mouse, these two we will use to give the input to the computer. By using keyboard we can type something, no? Then what we are typing, that will enter into the computer. Okay children. Next, processing devices. Processing devices means nothing but a process data. Process data. Next, memory devices. Memory devices means to store data. To store data. Output unit means to give results. To give results. where we will see the results in monitor or printer. This we will all see in next. Okay. Now see children, here I want to say how the computer will work. For example, we are giving input to the computer, and the computer will we will give input to the computer in the form of data. What the computer will do? The computer will process that data and gives the result. In the form of output. For example, here see, for example, I want to make a mango shake. Mango milkshake I want to make. Then what I will do? I will take a mixing jar, and what I will give as input? Smashed mango, sugar, milk. I will add in the mixer jar. Means these three are what? Input. Then what the I will switch on the mixy. Then what the mixy will do? It will churning by mixer. It will mix all the things. That is called what? Processing. Then at last what it will come? Mango milkshake it will come. What is that output? Now you understood what is input, what is processing, what is output. Input means what we will give to the computer. Input means what we will give to the computer is called input. And processing means what the computer process in the system by using CPU. That is called processing. And what result it will give, that is output. Okay, children. Now, see here. This is about different parts of computer. Input unit, keyboard, mouse, processing devices, CPU, memory devices, RAM, ROM, CD. In these devices, we will store data. Output unit to give results, monitor, printer, these are. Now, we will see briefly. Okay, children? See here. Actually, children, a computer should work, we want mainly two things or two parts. What are those means? Hardware and software. Without hardware, only software is there, computer should not work. Only software is there, hardware not there, computer should not work. How these are all happening, we will see. So children, first I want to explain you what is hardware. See children, computer hardware and software. A computer is made up of hardware and software. Hardware refers to the parts of the computer that you can touch and feel. Hardware means hardware refers to the parts of the computer that you can touch and feel. Means that parts we can touch and feel. Those are called hardware. Hardware of the computer. Example, see. Monitor, keyboard, mouse, printer, scanner and microphones. These are all examples of hardware. These are the physical parts of a computer system. They may be present outside or inside the computer. The CPU, monitor, keyboard, mouse, printer, scanner and microphone are the examples of the computer hardware. Hardware alone cannot make a computer work. It needs software to make it functional. So children, see, these computer hardware devices are, it may be inside of the computer and it may be outside of the computer. It may be present inside of the computer or it may be present outside of the computer. Okay children, like examples what? Monitor, keyboard, mouse, printer, scanner and microphone. If you see, shall we touch monitor? Shall we touch keyboard? Shall we touch mouse? So these are all the hardware devices. Next, coming to the software. What is a software? See children, software means it is a set of programs. Set of programs. Program means what? Nothing but programs means it is a set of instructions. Set of instructions. See, in order to understand what software is, you need to understand the term computer program. Computer program. Computer program is a set of step-by-step instructions that allows the computer to perform a task. Software is a set of programs or instructions given to a computer to perform a task. You cannot touch or feel the software of a computer. See children, what is a software? It is a set of programs or instructions. So, software is a set of programs or instructions given to a computer to perform task. Okay, and we cannot touch and see. Software means we cannot touch and see. See here children, you cannot touch or feel the software of a computer. You cannot touch and feel the software of a computer. Okay, this is called the software. Software is a set of programs or instructions given to a computer to perform a task. You cannot touch and feel the software of a computer. Okay, what are the examples of this software? MS Office, MS Paint, Google Search, WhatsApp, YouTube, CorelDRAW, and all apps. What we are using, those are all software. Those are all software. Those are all nothing but of instructions or programs. What we are going, what we are giving to computer. What instructions we are feeded in the computer. Those are all called software. What instructions we are installed in the computer. Those are called softwares. Shall we touch MS Office? Shall we touch WhatsApp? Shall we touch YouTube? Shall you touch and feel these CorelDRAW? Shall we touch Paint? Shall we feel Paint? No, no. So these are all softwares. Now we understood what are hardware and what are software. Hardware refers to the parts of the computer you can touch and feel. Monitor, keyboard, mouse, printer, scanner and microphone. Coming to software, it is a set of programs or instructions that we cannot touch and feel. Okay children, example, MS Office, Google, WhatsApp, YouTube, and what you are playing, games, those are all software. Okay children, so here this is about the hardware and software. Again, these hardware devices are divided into four types. Just I gave some little bit of introduction, no? Input, processing, and memory, output. I gave, no? Just introduction, that only. Now see, hardware devices are mainly divided into four types. Okay children, hardware devices are mainly divided into four types. What are those? We will see. See children, before saying this, I want to say something. See, when you boot up your computer system, the software system starts working in its hard disk drive. The computer uses an operating system. Popular operating systems are Unix, OS of Apple and Windows 10. Many application programs are also part of software. Some examples are MS Office, CorelDRAW, Adobe and Photoshop. I already said, no? What are the examples of software? Photoshop, CorelDRAW, MS Office, these are all examples of software. Software or programs can be stored in the hard disk. Where these softwares all are stored? Where these softwares all are stored? In hard disk. Okay children, next step. CD-ROMs and pen drives. You use these programs to work on the computer. The hardware helps you to run these programs and see the results. Thus, a computer needs both hardware and software to be able to function. So, children, these softwares all are stored in hard disk, pen drives or some compact disk. Okay, children, we will store these all in these memory devices. Okay, children, now see hardware. So, to function a computer or to work computer, what we want? We want two ways. Those are hardware and software. Hardware means the physical things are the parts which we can touch or feel. Software means a set of programs or instructions that we cannot touch and feel. Okay, children? Now, again, coming to hardware. Hardware devices are again divided into four types. That I already gave in introduction. What are those? Input devices, processing devices, memory devices, output devices. Okay, children, first we will see what are input devices. So see, hardware devices are mainly divided into four types: input units, processing devices, memory devices, and output devices. Okay, first we will see what are input devices. We will see. So, see children, input devices or input unit. These are used for enter data or instructions into the computer. Input devices. These are used for enter data or instructions into the computer. So, here children, for example, keyboard, mouse, joystick, light pen, microphone, scanner, etc. are the input devices. See, input devices are used to enter data. Data refers to, here I want to share one thing. What is data? Data means what? I am saying again and again, data, instructions, information, data, instructions, information. I am saying no. So, what is data? Data means collection of facts. Data means collection of facts like your name, address, phone number. These are all called data. For example, you joined in a school. You want to give your name, your address, your age, your date of birth, your phone number. Those are all we are feeding in our school. Those are called data. Okay, children. And coming to instructions. What are instructions mean? Commands. Commands what we are giving to the computer. Those are called instructions. Okay, children. And what is information? Information means what computer gives us in the form of result. Is called information. I will say one small example to you. See, children. For example, see here, I want to do a calculation in a computer. So, I entered 2 plus 3, enter. What the result will come? 5 automatically. Is it right? Here, see, what is 2? It's an input. What is 3? It's an input. And what is plus plus water, it's a instruction. Plus means it's a instruction. So what I am giving input means nothing but of data. I am giving data 2, 3. I am giving data in the form of 2, 3. Okay, I am giving 2 and 3 to the computer in the form of data, and I am giving a command and I am giving an instruction to the computer. Add. What I am giving instruction to the computer? Add these two numbers. Add these two numbers. I am giving the instruction. So here 2 and 3 are data, plus is instruction, and this arrow is it will process. It will process means it is taking data and instruction, and following this instruction, these data it will. So children, 2 and 3 are data, and plus is instruction. Nothing but of addition is instruction, and I am giving data, instruction, and the computer will process these two, taking data and instructions. Means what command I am giving here? Add 2 and 3. Here 2 and 3 are data, add is instruction. So following these all, and computer process and gives the result 5 in the form of information. Now we understood what is data, what are instructions, and what is information. Data is nothing but what we are giving to the computer. Instructions also what we are giving to the computer in the form of commands. And information means nothing but of what computer after processing it will give us in the form of result is called information. See what's information? After processing data, computer gives us result, that is information. Now you see here what, now see input devices used for enter data or instructions into the computer. So examples I said computer, keyboard, mouse. Keyboard you all of you know for typing. Mouse also you learned in last year to move the cursor and to give the instructions. And joystick also you learned to play games. When you are playing, no left button, right button you are pressing, no joystick, that is joystick. And light pen, if you observe sometimes we can write by using light pen, we can write on the monitor, that is called light pen. And microphone is also a input device, because it, by using microphone we can send our voice, we can send our words into the computer by using microphone. Microphone is nothing but by using microphone we can record our voice. So microphone is also a input device. And scanner is also a input device, because we can scan our photos. We are scanning, we put our photo on a scanner, that photo will enter into the computer in the form of a picture. Is it right? So scanner is also a input device. So these are all the examples of the input devices. Now you see keyboard. What is keyboard and how it will work we will see. See children, in your textbook page number 6, keyboard. The keyboard is the main input device of a computer. You type data, instructions into the computer using the keyboard. A keyboard has many buttons called keys. What is the keyboard will contain? Keys, many buttons called keys on it. Look at the keyboard and find out how the letters are arranged. The letters on a keyboard are not arranged in an alphabetical order. They are arranged in QWERTY order. They are said to be so because the first 6 letters of the alphabet keys are QWERTY. See children, in page number 7, keyboard picture is given, no? See here, there are alphabetical keys are there, no? Means all alphabetical letters are in order. See, is there are in order, alphabetical order? No. So, those are arranged in QWERTY order. What is meant by QWERTY order? See here, that yellow box was highlighted, no? The first six letters are QWERTY. That's why this keyboard we are calling QWERTY keyboard. Children, there are many keys on the keyboard for the sake of convenience. We divide them into sets. Let us study these sets. These are all we learned in third class. Cursor control keys, left arrow, right arrow, down arrow, up arrow. These all we learned in third class. So, how we will use these cursor keys? We want to move cursor left side, we can press left key, left arrow key. Right side cursor movement, right arrow key. Upside cursor movement, up arrow key. So, children, downward arrow key we will press to move the cursor downwards. Like that, see, number keys. 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. See here, upside of the keyboard, top of the keyboard, there are number keys are there. Like that, see, right side of the keyboard also, number keys are there. Like special keys, delete key, backspace key, enter key, space bar, tab, shift, caps lock, escape, etc. These are all we call special keys. You know now, for delete any letters or words, we can press delete key and backspace key. To come to the next line, we will press the enter key, space bar to give the space, and the tab key, we will give the space, shift key to type the capital letters, and caps lock key also to type the capital letters, and escape key also we will escape any window, it will appear on the monitor, we will press the escape key, etc. Next, functional keys, F1 to F12. Top of the keyboard you see, F1 to F12 functional keys are there. Like punctuation keys, colon, comma, semicolon, full stop, inverted commas, these are all punctuation keys. Symbol keys, plus, minus, star, slash, dollar, percentile, equal to, dollar, at the rate, brackets, exponent, hash, these are all symbol keys. These are all we learned in third class also. Already we learned in third class. So, these are all about the input devices. In that we learned keyboard, mouse. And coming to joystick, by using this joystick, we can play video games, no? You all know that well. Left button, right button, you are playing with the joystick. And light pen, by using light pen, we can write on the monitor. This is also input device. Microphone, by using microphone, we can record our voice. Means we are sending our voice into the computer. So that's why it is also an input device. Next, coming to scanner. This is also an input device. Why? Because, you know, now we will scan our photo and that photo will enter into the computer. And we will see that photo on the monitor. Which photo is outside in our hand, that photo we will see into the monitor. Means what? We are sending our photo into the computer. So, that's why this is also a scanner, is also an input device. Okay, children. Next, see here, mouse. We will see about mouse now briefly. See in your textbook 7, mouse. Mouse is another important input device of the computer. It is also called a pointing device. The movement of the mouse controls the movement of mouse pointer on the screen. In this way, you can point and select any object on the screen with the help of mouse. The scroll mouse is most common nowadays. It has two buttons on its front. It also has a scroll wheel in between the two buttons. Another most commonly used mouse is an optical mouse. It has light source at the bottom instead of a ball to sense movement. The four most important mouse actions are click. You can click button to select objects and draw figures. Double click. You can double click buttons to execute an instruction or to open a file. Right click. You can right click to see a list of commands. drag and drop. You can use a drag and drop to move an item from one position to another on the monitor. See children, we already learned about mouse in third class and second class also. Mouse having two buttons, left button and right button. In those two buttons, there is a wheel. That is called scroll wheel. You also know that, no? For which purpose we will call the mouse as a pointing device. See, if you move the mouse, the cursor also move. For example, I want to show you what is mouse. I am pointing here, no? This is mouse. This is input device. This is processing device. Like that, I am pointing. Is it right? So, mouse is also used for pointing devices. And we already learned mouse having two buttons. Those are right button and left button. In between there is a scroll wheel to scroll the screen. If you scroll the wheel, see my screen is scrolling now. Like that we can scroll our screen by using the scroll wheel. So children, nowadays optical mouses are coming. For that mouse down there is a light. It will show the sense of the movement of the that mouse pointer. Okay children, now see how the mouse will function, how the mouse will work. Click means single click. If you single click any object, the object will open. For example, you see, I am closing here. If you click this, it will highlight. If you click this, it will highlight. If you click this, it will highlight. Like that, by using single click, we will highlight this one. If you single click here, it will highlight. And if you want to move the cursor from one place to another place, we will use the mouse. For example, my cursor is here, hardware. I want to bring the cursor here, keyboard. Where you are pressing mouse button, there the cursor is moving. This is the use of single click. Next, what is double click? By using double click, we will give the instructions. For example, here see, I am giving double click. Then what it will happen? The word will selected. Like that, by using double click, we will select a word. And by using double click, we will open any program. Okay, children? Now see. And next, right click. If you click right click, it will comes a drop down list. Here, we will do any formatting like bullets, changing font color, and we can see, we can give bullets, we can give numbering like that. We will observe a drop down list by clicking the right click. And drag and drop. By using drag and drop method, we can drag and drop the objects on the monitor. For example, you see here, fourth class is there, no? This icon is here. I am pressing left mouse button and dragging it, and here I am dropping. Fourth class is here, no? Now I am dropping here. See. So like that, we can drag and drop by using mouse. These are all the functions of the mouse. Okay children, so these are all about the input devices. Okay children, now I am closing this class. In the next class we will see about processing devices and in the next class we will see processing devices, memory devices, we will see in the, and output unit, we will see in the next classes. Okay children, now I am going to close this class. What is your homework now today? You draw the keyboard picture and mouse picture in a rough notebook. You draw a keyboard picture and a mouse picture in a rough notebook. Okay children, so today I am closing this class. We will meet in next class. Till then, take care. Bye-bye. Thank you.